In this pandemic season, we are confined to our homes. We, the teachers, we miss you, all you lovely darlings, but happy to meet you through online classes. Please do attend the online classes regularly. And this is School Assistant English ZPSS Mukalpalli. I came to you to share with you something about how to edit a given passage. It's a vast subject, but I want to share with you in a nutshell. And this editing appears in the first paper of English, question number 13 to 17, and it carries 5 marks. It is an important aspect which you should concentrate on. Okay, now let's go into the subject. Editing. What is editing? What do you mean by editing? Editing is nothing but its correction of errors. While doing or while writing English, we do some errors and we have to correct them and we have to re-represent them or recompose them and rewrite them. Okay, so this is editing. And this is very important when you present a paper or when you present a book, when you write a book. So be careful, listen and learn. Okay, so let us see what are the different aspects or what are the different categories which are involved in editing a passage. Okay, so let's go. See here, you can observe the different categories which are involved in editing a passage or in editing a sentence in English. So let's see, the first one is missing words. While correcting a sentence, we have to see if any words are missing. Words in the sense, or whether there may be parts of speech, that is, okay, whether any contentions or prepositions are missed, and you have to replace them. Excess words, if any unnecessary words are there in the sentence, we have to remove them. Word order. See, we have to form a word order by constructing an English sentence. While we construct a Telugu sentence, we use Karta, Karma, Kriya. That is subject, object and verb. But while constructing an English sentence, we have to follow the order subject, verb and object. Then parts of speech. Parts of speech, you all know all the 8 parts of speech which are involved in English. See whether they are phrased or whether they are used perfectly. Okay. Then this includes articles. I am going to deal about articles in detail after this. Then tenses. As you all know that there are tenses are of 2 types, present and past. We have to see whether the passage in past tense or present tense. And we have to see whether the sentence is constructed in past tense or present tense according to the given passage. Then aspects. Aspects involve perfective, that is have, has, had. And have should be followed by being. Similarly, has and had should be followed by being. And has, have and had should always be followed by V3 of the verb form. And then progressive. Progressive in the sense it is continuous tense. So the verb should carry ing form. The verb should be in ing form while using the progressive tense. Then passive form. You have to see whether the sentence or the passage is in passive form or not. And so the sentence should also be in the passive form. So how to recognize whether the sentence is in passive form or in active form, as you all know, again, in the passive form. The verb always will be in V3 form and it will be followed by plus subject. Okay? Then, the PNG markers. PNG markers are nothing but person, number, gender. And I am again going to deal in detail with person, number, gender aspect. The case, that is possessive, mine, Ramas, Rani's, Raju's. So there we have to use apostrophe S. It is Rama's book. It is Rani's book. So there apostrophe S should be used. The affixes, prefix and suffix. We have to see whether the verb is having a prefix or suffix. Is the word which is used as a prefix or suffix is apt for the sentence or not? The writing conventions such as punctuations, capitalizations and spelling, it is a must. So these are the different categories which are involved in editing. So now, let's go into articles. Okay. So if you see passive speech, we have noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, prepositions, conjunctions, and interjections. And we have to pass. Okay, let's go to passive speech. As you all know, we have 8 different types of passive speech: nouns, pronouns, adjectives, verbs, adverbs, prepositions, conjunctions, and interjections. So in the given sentences, we have to observe whether the proper parts of speech are used or not, whether proper prepositions are used, whether proper conjunctions are used, whether proper interjections are used, and whether the adjectival or adverbial forms or noun forms are used. So we have to see whether the perfect words are our vocabulary are used. Right. Now let's see about the articles. Articles are 3 types: a, an, and the. As we all know, a and an are used for specifying one. Right. See here, we have a, an, and the. So a and an are used for single countable English nouns. We must always have an article before a single countable noun. Right. A book, a pen, a cat, a rat. So this is how we mention. And an apple. See the difference. The words which are beginning with consonant sounds are prefixed by a, that is a book. And the words which are pronounced in vowel sound and is prefixed. An apple. A European again. A European, but an apple, an egg. So this is how we have to see whether proper articles are placed in the sentence. Then, why we should not use articles? We should not use articles before uncountable nouns such as life, happiness, coffee, wood, etc. Yes, they are uncountable. We can't measure them. But here, again, there is an example where we use for a for coffee. I want a coffee. I want a coffee. A coffee here means I want a cup of coffee. When we go to a hotel, we order a cup of coffee or a coffee. Yes, there we can use a for coffee. Then, let's see where the is used. The is used to make general things specific, and we can use the way with any type of noun, plural or singular, countable or uncountable. Yes. And the names of the mountain ranges, the names of oceans, the names of rivers, they all carry the before them. The Ganges, the Krishna, the Godavari, the Himalayas, right? This is how we say. The Pacific Ocean, the Indian Ocean, there we use the. And there are some words which don't carry article at all. So, we have in page numbers 54 to 57 pages, in your English reader, class 10 English reader, from pages 54 to 57, you can observe where the articles are not used. So, go through them. Right. So, this is about articles. Next, we shall go to the next topic, PNG markers. Right. Now, let's come back to person, number, gender markers, PNG markers. Remember, P stands for person, N stands for number, and G stands for gender. So, what is person? First person, second person, and third person. Who is first person, who is second person, and who is third person? Yes. So, who is first person? I is the first person. And you is the second person. You are you, second person. And he, she, or it, third person. Now, let us see how we should use the verbs while we are using the person. Okay. So, let us see both the person and the number. Number means singular and plural. So, in singular, the first person is I. In plural, we. As for second person singular, it is you. And plural also, you. And for third person singular, it is he or she or it. And plural form is they, these, and those. So, how are the verbs used here? So, for I, it is am. The helping verb which we should use for I in present tense is am. I am. And if it is plural, we should use we are. We are. This is first person. Then second person. It is you are. Both for singular and plural, it is you only. So we have to use are after you. You are. And for third person, let us see for the third person. For he, she, and it, the helping verb which is used in present tense is. And for plural form of third person, they, these, and those, the helping verb which is used after these words are. After these, they, these, and those, the helping verb which we should use is are. Then, what is the helping verb which is used in the past tense? For I, it is was, and was. And for we, it is were, we were. And for second person, it is you were only in both the cases. And for third person, if it is he or she or it, we should use was after them. In past tense, he was, she was, and it was. And in plural form, we have to use the were, they were, these were, those were. Right? And our perfect form, when the sentence is in perfect form, that is present perfect, we have to use I have, or we have, or you have. But when it comes to third person, it is he has, she has, it has. And plural form, they have, these have, and those have. Right? And if it is in past perfect, we have to use I had, we had. Second person, you had. And the third person, it is he had, she had, it had. Similarly, they had, these had, and those had. So this is the agreement between the person and the number. Right? So let us see the next one, that is gender. Gender, it is two types, masculine gender and feminine gender. Okay, so in masculine gender, we have he and she. Sorry, we have masculine and feminine gender. For masculine gender, we have to use he, and for feminine gender, it is she. So when we mention he in the subject, in the object, it should be him. For writing in passive form, it should be him. And when we use the feminine form, that is she, in the subject, it should be her. In the object, when we write in passive form. And the other pronoun which is used for masculine gender is his. It is his book. It is Ramu's book. It is his own, his book, her book. Okay. The letter is written by him. He is a writer. These are his books which are written by him. He is a writer. These are his books which are written by him. Similarly, when it comes to feminine gender, she is a writer. These are her books. They are written by her. So, have you seen the difference? Have you noticed the difference? So, this is about the gender. Right. Now, let us go into an example from lesson 1, attitude is attitude. Shall we go, children? Right, let us go into an example. Let us take an example. So, let's see this example. This passage is taken from your first lesson, attitude is attitude. So, remember that the editing passage which appears in your question paper is taken from the reader. First paper editing passage is taken from the reader. So, you should be thorough with the lessons given in your reader. Okay, so be careful and please concentrate while reading on the lessons. Right. Now see here, we have five different sentences given. You can observe each and every sentence. There is an error in each and every given sentence. His parents decided not send him to a special school. A decision he said was very hard for him, but which may have been the best decision they could have made for him. See, there is an error in it. Can you point it out? Just don't look into your readers right now. Afterwards you can see. But now, you observe here and try to correct this. Okay. His parents decided not send him to a special school. A decision. See, if you read this sentence, you can easily find there is an error. There is a word which is missing. What is that word which is missing? Yes, Here, a preposition is missing. A preposition is missing. Yes, Arjun Ahmad, what is that preposition which is missing? But till then, you try to find out what is that missing preposition. Next, let us see the 14th one. When Nick was born, his father was too shocked that he left the hospital room to vomit. So here, there is an excess word or the word which is used wrongly here. In this sentence, there is a word which is used wrongly. That word should not be used there. Instead, there is another word which should be written. Right. See the 15th one. His distraught mother can't bring herself to hold him until he was 4 months old. Yes. In this sentence also, there is an error. Regarding tense, there is an error. Please find it out. Just try. Just don't open a book. Try. Look at the 16th one. His disabled came without any medical explanation, a rare occurrence called physomalia, and Nick and his parents spent many years asking why this cruel trick would happen to them. Yes. Here, there is a word which should be used in another form. So, the form should be changed. The form of that particular word should be changed. You observe there, you find it out and change it. Next, look at the 17th one. My mother was a nurse and she did everything right during pregnant, but she still blamed herself, he said. Yes, in this sentence also, the form of a word should be changed. A different form should be used. So you just find out what is that word whose form or should be changed. Okay? Right. Now try to do it. I'll be coming to you in few seconds with the answer. Yes. Welcome back for the solution. See, let's see the first sentence. His parents decided not to send him to a special school. So what is missing there? A preposition to is missing there. His parents decided not to send him. So the infinitive to is missing. So it should be written there. And mind you, you have to write the complete sentence after correcting the error. Just don't write the answer, but you have to mention the question number and you have to write the complete sentence after correcting the error. Let us see the 14th one. When Nick was born, his father was too shocked that he left the hospital room to vomit. This is what is given for you. But here, if you observe, there is a connective that. Right, that is there. So when that is given, that should be connected only with so. It should be connected only with so. So it should be so. Instead of two, two should not be used. If two is there, what is the connective there? Two. Two, two. But here, as that is given, it should be so. So two should be replaced with so. Next one, see the 15th one. His distraught mother can't bring herself to hold him until he was 4 months old. If you look at the passage given is in past tense. So, the verb which is you should be in past tense. So, instead of can't, it should be couldn't. Now, let us see the 16th one. Here, his disabled came without any medical explanation. A rare occurrence called physomalia. So here again, it should not be disabled. It should be the other form, disability. His disability. Right. See the 17th one. My mother was a nurse and she did everything right during pregnant, but she still blamed herself, he said. So again, it should be the other form of pregnant. It should be pregnancy. So the other form of the word. So this is how the errors occur in the given passage and you have to correct them and rewrite the complete sentence. Remember, rewrite the complete sentence. Don't just write the correction part or corrected part, but you have to write the complete sentence, right? Children, hope you have understood how to edit a given passage. Hope I am clear. I am clear to you all. If you have any doubts, you can post in the YouTube channel from through which you are watching this. And please be careful. Please practice, especially you need practice for editing. Please practice. Read the lessons thoroughly. All the ABC readings, please read thoroughly and practice them. Practice them. With practice only, you will be able to do editing perfectly. Okay? Wish you all good luck. Stay home. Stay safe. God bless you all.